here today for Lawn Fawn and welcome back to the channel. Today I have a congratulatory card to share with you all using the A Bug Deal stamp set as well as the Flippin' Awesome dies. I'm actually going to be using one of the add-on dies today because it comes with this cute little scalloped frame die and I thought it would just be perfect for my cut today. I'm starting off with stamping out all of the images from the A Bug Deal stamp set. I'm just using some jet black ink as well as some white cardstock and my Misty stamping tool to help me stamp multiples of these images. I ended up stamping a lot more than I initially used, but I have a lot extra for another card later on. So I'm going to be using Copic markers to colour in all of my images today. So I'm using a lot of the same colours just for lots of different items, just because I thought it was a lot easier and a lot quicker to do so. I'm starting off with some browns and I'm using E59, E57, E55 and actually E53. I do have E51 here, but it was a little bit too light to blend all of those together. And I'm just stamping, or coloring rather, all of the branches and the soil and also the worm with that same brown color, just for ease, as I mentioned before. After I finish colouring in the branches, I'm going to colour in all of the green areas. So again, I'm using all of the same greens for the leaves and the caterpillar and the grasshopper, and then also that little leaf on the top of the cupcake as well, just for simplicity. So I'm using YG67, YG17, YG23, and YG01 for those. I really love this color combination. It's a super bright green color and I just thought it matched the other bright colors that I'm going to use on this card as well really well. Next up, I'm coloring in the little Slater and also the cocoon and the speech bubbles, just using some really light gray markers. So for the Slater and the cocoon, I used W4, W2, W0 and W00. And then for the speech bubbles, I opted just to use the W2, the W0, and the W00, and then just blended that all together using the zero marker just to make them appear a little bit more white than the Slater and the cocoon, which I wanted to be a little bit more gray. Next up, I'm moving on to some orange areas. So I'm coloring in the bottom of the cupcake and a couple of the bodies of the butterflies with some oranges. I'm using YR16, YR14, YR00 and YR20 for those. Now I'm moving on to some pinks. So again, I'm coloring in the top of the cupcake and some areas of the butterflies as well with this hot pink color. I'm using RV19, RV25, RV13 and RV10 for that. And then for the last bit of coloring, I'm just going to be using some blue violet colors. So I'm using BV08, BV04, BV02 and BV01. And I'm just colouring in the rest of the butterflies that I had left over. So now that all of those are coloured in, I'm going to go ahead and cut them all out. So I went ahead and did that off camera. And then I'm just using some Blue Jay cardstock and cutting that down into a card front. So 4 inches wide by 5.5 inches tall. I always make my cards this size because I like them to be a little bit skinnier than a normal A2 sized card. I then went ahead and took out the Flippin' Awesome add-on dies and I just cut out those little extra pieces from the center and kept the scallop frame and the rectangle connected. Then I just went ahead and ran through that with some white cardstock through a die cutting machine to create 3 frames. Once they were all cut out, I just went ahead and arranged them onto my navy card front and just sort of overlapped them. So the 2 on the left are going to be under the 1 on the right. So I just went ahead and took a pencil and just marked out where they overlap on the top and on the bottom. And then once I've gone ahead and marked out those areas, I'm just going to take some scissors and cut along those pencil lines. I then added foam tape onto the back of each of the frames and adhered them down into place on my card base. So now that my basic framed layout is all complete, it's time to go ahead and add in all of the images. So I really love creating framed designs like this for when you have a lot of smaller images. Sometimes filling up an entire card can be really hard with a lot of small images, but sometimes having like mini frames to create mini scenes can really help with that. So that was my idea for this card today. I went ahead and added foam tape onto the back of the branches and adhered those into place. And then for the smaller branches, I just adhered them down using some glue tube adhesive and just scattered a couple of them around. I only made 5 branches, so I'd have an odd number since things generally tend to look better in odd numbers. I then went ahead and grabbed a few leaves, some of the munched leaves and some of the full leaves, and just scattered them around my project as well. I did a couple on the bottom and a couple on the top and one in the middle. Once I went ahead and adhered all those down, it was time to organize my little critters. So I ended up scattering around 5 of the flying critters. So I did 2 at the top, 2 in the middle, and 1 at the bottom. I then also went ahead and adhered one of the sliders, the grasshoppers, and then one of the worms at the very bottom as well. I added in some soil to the middle section. And I also added a cocoon in as well, just to finish off my little scene. Once I went ahead and finished adhering down all of the critters, it was time to work on the sentiment. So I wanted this to be a congratulatory card, so I decided to use the little speech bubbles that I had already cut and colored earlier, and just stamp the little yay that comes in the stamp set into the speech bubbles. So on one of them, I stamped 2 yays, and in the other, I just stamped 1 and then scattered them around my card as well. Then I decided to also add in a main sentiment, but you could leave this out if you wanted to. I think you could just stamp the rest of the sentiment in the inside of the card if you wanted to, but I decided to put a part of it on the outside. So I white heat embossed "This is a really big deal" on a black strip of cardstock, and just added it at a little bit of an angle on the left-hand side. I made sure that it overlapped the side of the card the same way the leaf does on the opposite side, just to tie it all in together really nicely. So that finishes up my card for today. I really hope that you guys enjoyed. All of the supplies will be listed down below and linked over at the blog, and I will catch you all next time.